Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu declared on May 5 that his government had unanimously voted to close down the local offices of Al Jazeera, a broadcaster owned by Qatar. Netanyahu announced the decision on X, but specifics regarding the implications, timing, and permanence of the closure remained unclear. This move marks an escalation in Israel's long-standing dispute with Al Jazeera and raised tensions with Qatar, particularly significant as Qatar is actively involved in mediating efforts to end the conflict in Gaza. Israel's contentious relationship with Al Jazeera stems from accusations of bias against the network. The government unanimously decided the incitement channel Al Jazeera will be closed in Israel, Netanyahu wrote on social media website X. Al Jazeera is one of the few international media outlets to remain in Gaza throughout the war, broadcasting bloody scenes of airstrikes and overcrowded hospitals and accusing Israel of massacres. Israel accuses Al Jazeera of collaborating with Hamas. Al Jazeera, the Doha-based broadcaster funded by Qatar's government, did not immediately respond to a request for comment. Al Jazeera's Arabic language broadcaster acknowledged news in its broadcast Sunday. Its English arm continued to operate with live shots from East Jerusalem just minutes after the announcement by Netanyahu. Earlier today, Benjamin Netanyahu rejected Hamas' demand for ending the war in Gaza in exchange for Israeli hostages, saying that would keep the Islamist group in power in Palestine, posing a threat to the former's country. He added that Israel will not accept terms that amount to capitulation. He vowed that Israel will continue the war in Gaza till its aims are achieved. Israel has been fighting a protracted war against Hamas since October 7, when the group's fighters stormed the former cities and killed 1,200 people, including women and children. The Health Ministry of Hamas-run Gaza said on Sunday that 34,683 people have died during the seven-month-old Israel-Gaza war. Over 78,018 people have been wounded in the Gaza Strip.